children that the word soldier means what it shouldn't. That terrorists look nothing like what the God in the TV says they should look like. Tell them monsters do exist, desiring their skulls souvenired, their limbs mosaicked, and their truths tarnished again. Tell them their names, faces, and overgrown memories are landmines. Landmines targeted by grenades and terrorism, white uniform terrorism, and that the pavements are tiled like a board game or some sort of mundane alleged raillery, and national heroes roll dices, roll corpses after posing with them, homecoming and championed, and clueless audiences will strip them of their rights without thought or prayer. Tell Afghani children that these soldiers too were someday children, but they never knew what it's like to home themselves under the rubble. What's it like for homes to escape us, to evade us, to become sheltered only in numbing faith? Tell them that regardless of all this, they should math their anger, check for beards on their faces before flights, bleach their tongues and assert submission. Tell them that floral definitions have failed me, that distrust is mandatory, distress is blanketed and bedrolled. I wake up once or twice every single night, and children wake up inside of me, hurt, alert, and blown up like a fucked up metaphor of confetti. Tell them that trauma is not something to remember, but it is something to relive, and relive, and constantly relive. Tell Afghani children that they are going to walk life censorious. Even the breeze will seem minatory. Tell them that we live in a world where monsters are excused, forgiven, and even adulated. Tell them the smell of the war machines will continue to haunt them, that some people have invidious breath, that this fear will wizen, branch into complex mental disorders and shivers. The day will begin to generalize. Tell Afghani children that wandering is a luxury, and so is looking just to look. Tell them that they know what Iraqi children, Palestinian children, Syrian children, and children of brown color know. That even assiduous grandmothers cannot take the pain away.